In this video, I'm talking about the most futuristic hearing aid on the planet, the Earlens light-driven hearing aid. Coming up. Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Anthem, Arizona. And on this channel, I cover a bunch of hearing related information to help make you a better informed consumer. So if you're into that, consider hitting the subscribe button. Back in 2016, I had the privilege of being one of the first audiologists to fit and program a pair of commercially available Earlens hearing aids. And I was super excited to do so at the time because the Earlens light-driven hearing aid completely changed the way that traditional hearing aids worked. Now, what do I mean by light-driven hearing aids? I'm not talking about the hearing aids being solar powered or anything like that. I'm talking about the infrared light technology that they use to stimulate hearing. But instead of trying to explain it myself, I'm gonna go ahead and let Earlens explain.
The Earlens light-driven hearing aid has three major parts: the photon processor, the light tip, and the lens. The small custom-fit lens is placed in your ear by an ear, nose, and throat physician. The lens stays in place on your ear the same way a contact lens stays in place on your eye, with surface tension. Sound enters the microphones on the rechargeable behind-the-ear processor. The processor communicates the sound to the light tip, which converts the sound into non-visible light. The light signals the lens to gently activate your natural hearing system.
Traditional hearing aids amplify sound acoustically, but instead of amplifying sound acoustically, the Earlens devices will convert this sound into an infrared light that will cause a mechanical vibration of the lens that sits on your eardrum. And instead of acoustically amplifying sound, you're essentially mechanically amplifying sound. But what's the main benefit of amplifying sound with infrared light mechanically versus amplifying sound acoustically with the traditional hearing aid? When you amplify sound with light, you can actually increase your frequency bandwidth. So instead of being restricted to only about 6,000 Hz with a traditional hearing aid, you can get all the way up to 10,000 Hz with the light-driven hearing aid. Now, why is this important? Well, the high frequency components of speech are what dictate clarity. So if you're looking for more clarity from speech, you need to make sure that you're amplifying as high frequency as possible, and Earlens lets you do that. In addition to the potential improved clarity in speech, you also may be at less likelihood for feedback or that whistling sound that you get from traditional hearing aids if you have too much leakage of that sound. One of the other benefits that Earlens claims to be able to do is because they're amplifying sound mechanically, it puts you at less likelihood for this leakage of sound. However, in my experience, if you do have more of a severe high frequency hearing loss, that vibration that's caused by that light stimulating the lens will actually create its own vibration, which could leak outside of your ear and cause that feedback sound. In terms of candidacy for Earlens, the requirements are very similar to that of traditional hearing aids. However, if you do have any kind of issues with your eardrum, you probably will not be a candidate, and if you have a conductive hearing loss, you probably won't be a candidate either. However, if you are a candidate for Earlens devices and you want to experience the increased high frequency benefits that Earlens could potentially give you, there are a few things that you need to put up with, and the first one is cost. There are a lot more steps in the process of getting Earlens devices as opposed to traditional hearing aids. First and foremost, you will have to get a hearing test and you'll have to have a consultation from an audiologist. You'll then have to have a consultation from an ear, nose, and throat physician. Once you've met those candidacy requirements, you will then have to get an impression made of your eardrum by the ENT. Once that is sent off to Earlens and they send back your custom lens, the ENT will then have to place that custom lens on your eardrum. Once you've had that placed on your eardrum, they will then send you through to the audiologist again, and they will actually put the light tip in your ear and the behind the ear device behind your ear and program your devices. So there is a lot more steps in this process in order to get an Earlens device as compared to a traditional hearing aid. The clinic that I used to work in had to charge $12,000 for a pair of Earlens devices. So it is significantly more expensive than getting even the best traditional hearing aids. The second thing that you have to be willing to deal with is the added inconvenience of using Earlens. On top of all the additional office visits that I previously mentioned, you're dealing with multiple different providers that have to make sure that they stay on the same page with each other, and sometimes communication could break down, which could create an issue if you end up having problems with your treatment. Since this technology is really new, you don't really know what to expect with treatment in terms of how consistent the treatment will be. In fact, when I was first treating someone with these ear lens devices, I had one case of where an individual smiled, it cut off the amplification. And it doesn't seem like that big of a deal until you realize you can't really go throughout a whole day without smiling, and if you do smile, you end up missing things that people are saying to you. The third thing that you have to be willing to deal with is the size of the devices. Because they put lithium batteries inside of their technology, which is great from a rechargeability standpoint, it does make their devices a little bit bigger. And on top of that, they don't have a bunch of different color styles. So you aren't going to be able to custom match that to your hair color, which would blend it in the most. But if you're someone who doesn't care about the way that your hearing aids look or the size of them, then you don't have to worry about it. Ultimately, my experience with Earlens was mixed. When they work really well. When they don't work, they really don't work. And in my opinion, Earlens has some things that they need to work out with their technology to make it more consistent with their users. And when they do, I think that they might be onto something. But until that time, if you're using traditional hearing aids and they aren't working for you, assuming they've been fit and programmed appropriately using real ear verification, then you may want to give Earlens a try to see if that increase in high frequency amplification can give you additional benefit. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you liked the video, please share it. And if you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I'll see you next time.